So I ran this on a server with a GPU, and it mostly worked without issues. The only thing was I forgot this the first time, so I trained it, but then didn't actually save the model, and had to run it again. But now it's saved on this computer, and there was also an issue. I'd forgotten to put this on the device, but that was easy to solve. So, the next step is to try to actually run the vision transformer. So I have it saved here, vit.pd. So I'm going to make a separate file to do this, and then include the vision transformer. So I think I'm going to need to do this again to get the tensor for the image I want. So I need to do the same image transform that's being done here. So vit.trainTransforms. Transform. Okay, so we're going to read some image in and then turn it into the tensor. And then I think we just do model.eval. So I think right now we just have forward and space as options, which, yep, so W is forward, otherwise it's returning one. Okay. Okay, let's try it. So it's doing something. Oh, I left the... The device says CUDA. Thank you. So I need to add this when I load it, to load it directly to the CPU, I guess. So I think this is what it's telling me that it wants. Oh, because I'm not doing the batch. Do the state dict or the whole thing? No, the whole thing. So I'm not quite sure what this eval is doing. But I guess I can just run it with that. Okay, so I think it's expecting like a list of images. So this example, they used the data loader again. Okay. I wonder if I can just make it myself with one, with just one image at a time. So I just need to like reshape this somehow. So the issue is, I have this image tensor, and I think Torch wants a list of these, because that's how it was originally trained, with 64 batches at a time. So it looks like it's not really encouraging me to do this. Guess I can try this. Okay, so let's see what shape this is. Okay, so this is channels, X dimension, Y dimension. So 4, 56, 56. So we want length 1, 4, 256, 256. Or no, we want the batch size here. Batch size. And then x0 equals image tensor. misspelled zeros.
Okay, so when I ran this earlier, it crashed my whole laptop. I think the issue was I ran out of RAM. This laptop only has 4 gigabytes plus swap. But I found out that this dimension here didn't actually have to be the batch size. I could just do 1. And so when I did 1 instead of 64, it used a lot less memory and it seems to run fine now. So, I'm reading the screenshot in as a tensor, and then getting an output, which I have here. So I think what we're looking at here are that these are the two classes. So I'm assuming closer to 1 is it selecting that class, and 0 or negative is not selecting that class. So the two classes I have are W, which is forwards, or not W. So the hope would be to see some difference in action based on what the screenshot looks like. So okay, so here's a screenshot. So it's got wide open space. And the action it actually took was moving forward. So let's see what the model says. I don't know how much of this time is the model running versus just loading Torch in. Because if it's this slow, I couldn't like run inference once a second to do this real time. So it selected not forward. Let's look at another one. Okay, so again, wide open space. And in the training data, it moves forwards. And they all seem to be almost exactly the same thing, and selecting the not forward class. Let's look at a couple more. There's another one. There's plenty of space in front. Key D. Okay. The same deal. But in this case, it was the same choice as in the training data. Do one more. So again, it's kind of normal space in front. This was another one that wasn't D. Okay, the same thing. So just to recap, we did the classes like this, so if it was so we either did forwards or not forwards. And when we're running it, the model after training, it seems to always choose not forwards, which I wonder if, this isn't running, but I wonder if just because the majority of the data has that, Oh, here we go. Yeah. So unfortunately, I didn't add space new lines in the action files. So there are some key W's, but a lot of not W's. Remember, I just looked at the frame before and after to find the ones that move forward. So here's some W's. But it looks like the trained model is never actually selecting W. So I think it probably just overfit on, I don't know, always not W. So I guess the things I could do would be to try training another one with all of the classes. And so then hopefully the most common thing would be W. So if I was choosing anything, it would just go with W. And I could also try a bigger model or more data. I had about 6,000 frames for this model. But yeah, I think I'd have to go back to the drawing board on this one. So I think that's probably a good place to stop for now, but thanks for watching.